This video is going to show you how to install the Mark VI GTI front splash guards. Part number 5K00751111. These are about 50-55 bucks plus shipping. First step, of course, take off your wheel, set up a jack stand, a jack, and now you're ready to start working in this area. So the first thing you want to do is remove these two bolts. These are the two lower outer bolts on your splash guard. You then want to set up your splash guard and put those bolts back in. So while you have it hanging there with your two bolts, you are going to mark the holes here at the bottom, and there's a hole underneath with a little Sharpie. Then you're going to take the splash guard off again, drill your three holes, then you are going to slide two of these clips at the bottom two holes you drilled, and then you're going to screw in the new screws, which is what I'm doing now. You have to go in at some angles, find the holes and all that. Might not be perfect. For your bottom hole, you're going to use a nut and a screw. The nut goes on top above the piece you drilled, and you screw in. That's how you tighten this bottom flap, which is right here. This last part is a bit tricky. It took me a while to figure out. I folded a flap that was sticking out here around the back, under the metal. And this is the flap we're talking about. It's rubber. So I pushed this back out of the way, bent that back in. Then you have a little right angle piece. The lip of the angle is going to go in this slot right here. So your lip is going into this slot, fits in there. Then you're simply going to push your clip over it, however, not over the whole thing. You have the two little channels that are going to go into these, into those holes. So you're not putting the clip over the entire thing. You're going into these tubes, and the back part of the clip is going to go over the metal. And it's going to be really hard, so I'll work on that a bit more now, but that's the basic idea. That keeps it real tight here. This was a little bit shaky at first, but I can see once you get this clip in, it's going to make it really tight and flush right here. So this was not as easy an install as it looked by any means. I thought this would be cake. I've probably been here almost a half hour on this one side. Of course, you want this here so you don't scratch it up. Then you're going to kind of go like this. Nice. Just clips right in. No markings. Perfect. I did it till it stopped. You can kind of feel it going through each channel and click. Make sure that's definitely all the way in. Perfect. Force, it's that hard. It takes this kind of pressure. What it takes to move this edge into the fender here real tight. Otherwise you'll see a big gap. You won't like it. To be honest, I trimmed a little bit of this also. I'll show you on the one I haven't installed. Say you have it up here and this edge here that my fingernail is touching. This here goes right against this. and it was not letting it seat all the way. It's sitting against that, and it couldn't push against the paint. So I did trim off at least half of this outcrop just on this little section here, so it can then lay against here a lot tighter. It was so long that this thing was in the way for it to sit fully. So that's really the most perfect install I can do. It's completely tight everywhere. Really nice piece. Show you the final result. Real tight. All the way. It has a little, nice little molding there that goes into the crack. Nice little channel there that goes up there. Here you can see the bolt I was talking about, the nut above it, which is almost impossible to see. You kind of got to get your fingers, there's the nut. You get your fingers up in that hole and place the nut carefully and screw up into it. And on this side, nice and tight, all the way. So this is good quality, and I am happy about these, even though the install was a bit more of a chore than I expected. The piece I was talking about trimming, this is how much I cut off so it could then sit flush against your stock splash guard, just for reference. If you do find any not great fitting at the top, that's what you can do. The clip would force this in, but it would also just put pressure on the splash shield, move it out of a natural place. So it kind of makes sense to shave off a little of that indent at the top so it can sit a little tighter and the clip requires a little less force. Don't forget to torque your wheels before you drive away.